Lapin's Kitchen now in West Houston. We've jetted over here, and she is a registered dietitian. And we're decoding your dining menu options. So what does that menu really mean? What are you really putting into your body? And how can you make some adjustments? So, Carol, I asked our viewers how many calories they thought should be on their dining plate, right? So how many should be on there?
So if we're making an assumption that you need around 2,000 calories, which is really the average female, having a dinner with 600 calories or less is really a good way to go.
600 or less.
Yeah, so you can spread the calories out, you know, maybe 500 or 400 for breakfast, 500 for lunch, and then some snacks left over during the day.
Okay, so we're looking at this plate. How have you altered it so that it's a little healthier than what you typically
would get
straight off the menu? Yeah. What adjustments can
you
make?
So we're trying to make the restaurant plate look like the My Plate, the USDA My Plate. So as you know, we're not going to go to most restaurants and go heavy on the produce, right? It's going to be heavy on the meat, heavy on the starchy vegetables, mm-hmm. you know, maybe fries, like French fries and that type of thing. So if we could do more veggies on the plate, do substitutions in place of the French fries, you know, ask your chef, ask your restaurant owner, your local restaurant owner, if they can provide more produce and do those types of substitutions, you're going to get better nutrition for lower calories.
So they may not say, hey, do you want vegetables on the side?
Right.
They may just say baked potato, French fries,
right.
you know, scalloped potatoes.
Ask.
You have to specifically ask for that.
Okay. What comes with this meal? How is it cooked? What substitutions could I make? Is it cooked in butter, which most of the cases it will be? Could I substitute a little bit of olive oil? Could I do a little lemon juice with that? If you're doing fish or chicken, could I do a little splash of wine on top of that?
You had a really great tip with vinegar as well.
Yeah, so you know, the vinegars now, they come, they're infused, they come in so many different flavors. The vinegar keeps things moist, you know, without adding the fat. So it's also a great substitution. And if you're doing the vinegar and oil for your salads, you can do a little more vinegar than oil, and you can save a lot of calories that way.
So I want to go through some appetizers then. I'm going to go through some things that are not so healthy choices, and I want you to give me some alternatives.
Okay.
So you say try to stay away from pate, cream soup, cheese soup, or dip. That includes the artichoke dip, unfortunately. Quiche, fried vegetables, egg rolls, nachos, and gumbo from Rue.
Right. So really what we're doing is garden fresh is a good way to go, whether it's veggies or salad. Anything poached, and you know, seafood makes a great appetizer. It also makes a great main course, but you could do your boiled shrimp with a little cocktail sauce. You could do the lump crab meat, you know, instead of doing, you know, the fried crab meat. So those are great options. Your broth-based soups, even though they'll be high in sodium, they'll be lower in calories than the creamy soups.
Okay, and then I want to go through 8 different pieces of advice you have so that we're prepared the next time we go, okay? We will be fully prepared.
Okay.
The first thing you say is be assertive.
Right. So what you want to do is ask questions. If I'm ordering a piece of fish or piece of meat, how many ounces is it? Is it cooked in butter? Could you leave the butter off of it?
Okay.
Substitutions. And then one other piece of advice, have the waiter or waitress repeat back what you said so there won't be mistakes made in preparation.
You say that over-consuming starts oftentimes before the meal is served.
Exactly.
I love my chips and my salsa, Carol, when I go to that Mexican restaurant.
And that's perfectly fine if you could pull out 5 to 6 chips and have 125 calories instead of eating the whole basket and eating 1,000 calories. You know, be aware of what you're having. But don't go starved. When you go out to eat, you want to be a little hungry, but don't go starve because then everything's out the window.
And then side dishes. We've covered that for the most part, but you see, be aware of those. Those are going to add a lot of additional calories.
And like I was telling you earlier, I had ordered a avocado salad, and the avocado came fried.
Who would have thought?
So you do need to ask, how was that prepared?
Choosing a la carte meals, also a good way to go.
Excellent idea, because if you're doing a la carte, you can put together the way you want it. Say you want to have 3 vegetables, or you want to have the taco, but you don't want to have the beans and the rice.
Mm-hmm.
You need the tacos in a salad, so do your own side dishes together.
I've heard this before, but splitting a meal or even considering an appetizer as your main course.
Right. Several appetizers. So if I want to do the lump crab meat, or I want to do the shrimp cocktail and add a salad or soup with that, wow, it's low calories, it's filling, it's nutritious, you know, as well.
I love all the options.
Yeah.
Okay, and then you say also finish last. Don't be the one that finishes first.
Right. So we know it takes, you know, about 20 minutes or so for the stomach to signal the brain that you're full.
Okay.
Slow it down. Put your fork down. Enjoy every bite. Have a little sip of water or iced tea in between your meals. You know, pace yourself. What you'll find is that you'll get full earlier on, and maybe you won't complete that plate and take some home for the next day.
So let's say I do splurge and I get the French fries and the hamburger.
Right.
But this is all, you know, hypothetical, because of course I would never do that.
No.
May or may not have done that at Kenny and Ziggy's over the weekend, but I think to myself, you know what, this day is already out the window. I'm going to go home and enjoy the popcorn and potato chips.
Right. So I think the mindset should be, hey, every now and then I'm going to blow it. That's fine. I'm going to go over the calories I need. But let's stop there. Let's not make it the entire weekend of blowing it.
And then you've got a great website that with lots of great information if people want to read further.
So what we know is that eventually all the chain restaurants of 20 or more will have calories posted in the nutrition facts label if you want it. But that hadn't happened yet, and that's not going to be happening for our little local restaurants. So you can go to HoustonRightDining.org. We've started with Nico's posting. You know, invite your chef and your favorite restaurant to send their healthy choices so you can go look at
Excellent.
It and make sure it is.
All right. Thanks so much, Carol.
Thank you.
And we are also going to post on our website, MyFoxHouston.com, no matter what kind of cuisine it is, Greek, Chinese, Japanese, Italian, you name it, those healthy choices on the menu. Again, on MyFoxHouston.com.